Hello, welcome to Transstar Galactica. This week's question comes from a viewer, and the question is, as a trans person, when we see someone in public we suspect is also trans, is there a way to connect without making them feel clocked, or is it better not to? Also, should there be a way for trans people to identify with each other in public by a gesture, symbol, or handshake? To answer the first question, whenever I greet somebody, before they're all of the minutiae that they are, they're a person, and I try to greet each person with the same positive and humane regard. We don't have a gender-neutral third-person singular pronoun in the English language. What I mean by that is that we have to choose he or she, or we have to use the word they, or one, or refer by somebody's name, which is a limitation. It makes the situation awkward if you know that someone is trans, but that person is not overt about their gender identity, and they don't want to be revealed, and they haven't given you a specific pronoun. You notice that different people refer to me as he or she or just as Sama, and I don't mind that very much. I'm actually fine with it, because until I have some word that validates trans as a valid gender, I'm not really preoccupied with choosing one. I just can't give that kind of authority to a word as something that identifies who I am when it doesn't accurately do that. No, I can't settle for 75% of the way in either direction. When you greet somebody who is trans, it's not a club and it's not exclusive. And if we as trans people want to be included, I think that we should be the first people to make being different a non-issue by treating everybody the same. When Julie and I went to testify, I think it was last year, in front of Maryland House and Senate for equal marriage rights for same-sex couples, a woman sat next to us who was trans, and I said the same thing I said to everybody. I said hello, and I also said thanks for coming, just because she sat there. I didn't know that she was a doctor. I didn't know that she was running for a seat in the state House of Representatives. I didn't know any of these things about her. I didn't know that she was a brilliant writer with a lot of creative ideas, that she was so many great things. So, with all the things that she is, why would I call her out on one particular external observation? I don't think I could do that. That might be all I have to say on the issue. Now, about identifying each other in public by a gesture, a symbol, or handshake, I do like the transgender symbol that we have, but I don't think it's a good idea to use some sort of secret handshake, because it's not an exclusive club. Again, I want to see the transgender community be integrated into all the other communities. You wouldn't call somebody out by their race, so why call them out by their gender? If you just see them as people, I think that's plenty. Humanity is really where it starts. So, I wish I had more to say about it, but I guess I don't. But I do want to share one piece of incredible news, that is that D.C. ratified... marriage rights to same-sex couples, and Maryland's Attorney General allowed for respective out-of-state marriages. So Julie and I are actually going to be married before too long, hopefully in April, and then we'll have a celebration in autumn like we had originally planned. We've just been waiting for rights. We've just been waiting to be treated equally. So it actually ties in very nicely, because we don't have to do any extra special paperwork. It is a little tough because we have to fill out the spouse's name and the sex and the gender and all these other things. But that's fine. It's fine. Yeah, it's wonderful. So if I want to be respected under the law and respected socially, then all I have to do is respect others. I think it's that easy. I think I've beaten the topic to death. Okay. That's enough for the week. I'll see you next week. Take care. Bye.